morning, we have Javier and Rebecca Chacon, they're missionaries to Peru, and I have just met them this morning, so I don't know a whole lot about them, other than Javier is from Peru, and is desiring to return there to serve as a church planter in the Junco region of Peru. Rebecca, his wife, is from Alaska, so you got, Alaska and Peru, the jungle from the tundra, so quite a span of geography there. But they are going to also be sharing their ministry during the Sunday school hour, so I invite you and encourage you to stay around for Sunday school to hear the ministry that God has given to them, and even to consider whether this is a couple that God would call us to partner with and join in the work that God has called them to as well. So that's something that we want to consider individually and certainly as a church as well. So with that, Javier is going to be teaching and preaching God's word to us this morning, and we're grateful for him. So thank you for being here this morning.
Huh?
No power. It's not time for us.
Yeah.
Well, good morning, everyone.
Buenos dias.
Well, I'm glad to be here. It's a privilege for me and my family to be here. That's Pastor Say, and this is Truly. I'm from Peru. My full name is Javier Chacon Gabriel. The Lord gave me the opportunity to meet a beautiful girl in Peru. So I didn't need the necessary to move to Alaska to find my wife. So the Lord gave to me. So, and praise the Lord given us good churches visiting around the state. We start our invitation time and last year, but I will share more about what God is calling us in the Sunday school. But we're really glad to be here. Thank you, pastors, for the opportunity to be here and share with you the Word of God, but also share our burden for the people in the world. Thank you so much for the family, Mrs. Donna and her husband and family, for giving us the opportunity to be with them in their house. This house is such a blessing. Well, I would like to share this morning about not just the burden of missionaries, but also the burden of God. So, we were talking about this morning about the challenge of missions. Please now, let's pray before we open our Bibles. Heavenly Father, thank you so much for the opportunity to be here in your church. And also thank you so much, Father, for your people here in your house. And I pray, Father, that you give us wisdom, open our eyes, open, Father, our minds, Father, our hearts, and your word. And help us, Father, to be obedient, not just to do hearing the word, but also with obedience, Father, every day in our life. And as we say to the Father, I pray that you give me freedom, because you know my heart, you know my mind, Father. And also I pray that you give me the words so people can understand clearly the good word for his life. And I pray, Father, for those things and that praise in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
No, oh, he doesn't have a gun there, don't worry about it.
All right, there you go. Thank you so much. Well, if you have your Bible, please turn your Bibles and the book of Acts, chapter 1, verse 8. This is, many of you know this verse, and Acts chapter 1, verse 8. And we will see in this passage the challenge of missions. I was here in a volunteer there, mission conference on August 2nd, November, right? A series message. And we'll start this morning reading in the book of Acts chapter 1, verse 8. We will see the challenge. What is the challenge about missions? The Bible said in chapter 1, verse 8, said, "But you shall receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you. And you shall be witnesses to me in Jerusalem and in all Judea and Samaria and to the end of the earth." So this morning, dear brothers and sisters, I want to share with you, with all of you, three principles for our life about missions. But not just when we talk about missions. The first principle that I want to share with you is, when we talk about missions, dear friends, brothers, we need to understand clearly that missions begin with the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen? Amen? You believe that?
Amen.
Amen. Because without the power of the Holy Spirit in our life and the ministry that you are involved, all that we can do